Hey guys, it's Ross and I'm in the greenhouse today. And I thought I'd do an unboxing video for you guys and see the plants that I've just received. I think it's just pretty interesting. I've watched a couple unboxing videos myself and I just find them interesting. I have no idea why. I think today's video is going to be more than just that. More than an unboxing video. And reason for that is because I have some interesting plants I received. Most of them are, actually all of them are tropical plants. I think, actually some of them are subtropical, but the large majority of them just will not survive here. All of them will not survive here outside if I left them outside. And what I'm gonna end up doing is actually keeping them here in the greenhouse full time. I'll bring them outside when it gets warm out, but these are the type of trees that I received that are very tropical, the majority of them, and just will not do well when temperatures are below 60. They'll survive below 60, but what's interesting is that I can't really plant them in the greenhouse, because if I plant them in here, you know, if you look around, it's this ceiling here is about 7 feet tall. So if a tree were to get taller than 7 feet tall, it just wouldn't work. And most subtropical trees, they're very vigorous trees, and they just won't work in the greenhouse. So I'm gonna keep them in containers, and I'll show you. Let me just show you what the hell I'm doing here. Let me just show you what's in these boxes here. This is a box I got today from a company called Logies. I think they're in New England. Connecticut, somewhere in the north like that. Much colder than where I live. It is pretty cold where I am compared to the majority of the United States. But they're much colder than us, and they're actually growing quite a bit of tropical plants in their greenhouses there at the nursery of Logies, which is really interesting. Fig trees or temperate trees, temperate fruits. I like all different types of fruit, and I think it's interesting. I just think it's interesting to try different fruits that you've grown yourself. I think it's a little bit more interesting than actually just going out and buying the fruit and tasting it, or you know, getting some like tropical fruits that you can't grow and mail ordering them. I think it's even better if you can somehow grow them yourself and get to taste them and see how well they do in containers. I think this whole thing here is just a giant experiment, and I just love that. I love that about growing, and I love that just in general in life, and I think this is going to be just some really interesting stuff to keep you guys updated on. In fact, right in front of me I have a star fruit tree, and behind that I have a lychee tree. But let's look at these plants here. I think I got 6 or 7 plants from Logies. And Logies is great because they are like me and they like to experiment with different types of plants in containers because they live in such a horrible climate for growing things. They really do. So they really just try to experiment and see what they can get away with fruiting in containers. And they, on their website, they have quite an extensive list of varieties of different, way different things that you can grow. This right here is, what is this? Let's see, let's get the tag out. So this is a Barbados cherry. You can see it there. I hope it's a Barbados cherry, because that's what I ordered. But, yeah, this is a Barbados cherry. It's quite small. But the thing is with these tropical fruits is that they actually grow really quickly. So I'm not too upset that this is very as small as it is. It's cheap. In fact, the prices I got on a lot of this stuff was really cheap. And it really just makes this whole experimenting thing worthwhile and much easier to do. Just because they're so much cheaper. What else is in here? Let's see. Another pretty small plant. I wish I could have someone filming me. It's so much easier to open this up. Any volunteers? Let me know. I think I'm gonna unwrap all this stuff, come back to you, and show you what I got. So, give me a minute. So this is what I ended up with. I got 5 plants shipped in the mail, and one of them is currently on back order, which will be shipped at a later date for free, actually. But right here, right in front of me, is a mango tree. And I think the mango, I'm going to actually just try to grow this in the house, like a citrus tree. Citrus would actually do well in the greenhouse during the wintertime. But I'm thinking that the citrus and, well, maybe not the citrus. At some point, maybe I might move a citrus out here into the greenhouse. But I'm thinking that this mango might be the one that I should, if any of them, move into the house, because they don't really like the colder temperatures. And I, based on my research, this is kind of what I found, is that these mangoes should be kept in the house, and they actually will do well in the house. And what I read and what I saw on their website is that they actually have a variety called a Pickering mango. And it just does really well in containers, and it actually fruits at a very early age. This mango that I got right here is called Nam Doc Mai. Let's give the camera a second to focus. It's called Nam Doc Mai, and Nam Doc Mai is said to be one of the best dessert mangoes you can have. I don't really know how well it does in containers, but I'm assuming if Logies is selling it, it probably does pretty well in a container. So I'm excited to try a mango that isn't store-bought. I don't believe I've tried a mango that isn't store-bought. In fact, I've only tried the one variety you get from the store. And they have quite a lot of fiber. I heard that mangoes are one of those fruits that just do really well when you grow them, and they actually taste better, and it's a world of difference. So I'm hoping that's true. Second I have here is a loquat, and it's a Christmas loquat. And loquats are quite hardy, believe it or not. I think they're hardy down to like 15 degrees or something like that. 15, 18, 20 degrees. They're a subtropical tree. I just want to say right up front, this was just very well packaged. These plants are in excellent condition. I'm not sure I've ever received a potted plant in this grade of condition. They fit so well in the container. I think they really, or in the box, I should say. I think they did a really nice job. What's interesting though about loquats is that they're one of those fruits, and this is a Christmas loquat. This is the variety called Christmas. And it's called that because it ripens around Christmas time, I think, or blooms around Christmas time. One of the two. Point is, it's a very nice fruit to have because they kind of taste like apricots. Something like that, like an apricot plum, I believe. It's like they're somewhere in the middle of that. And I can grow them here, apricots and plums, no problem. It's just that the season ends at a certain point, you know? So this loquat is like a plum or an apricot that ripens for me in the wintertime, which is really nice to have fresh food at that time of the year. It's similar to like citrus. And that's really what I like about this. A lot of these trees in the greenhouse that I'm gonna have, these tropicals, is that if I can get them to fruit in the off season, I mean, that is just amazing. So this is like, this tree was probably my number one pick just for that reason. And that's really why I like citrus so much. Not only because they're tasty as hell, it's just really nice to have stuff that fruits for you in the wintertime. And then down here, I've already showed you guys the Barbados cherry. Is it the Barbados cherry? Yeah, this is the Barbados cherry, this little guy right here. This is an Australian beech cherry. And then this right here is a strawberry tree. And I've looked all these guys up and looked at people actually tasting the fruit. They actually seem quite into them, and they seem to do well in containers. They're quite productive because cherries are really small. It's a very small fruit, similar to how a lychee would be right here. They're just a very small fruit, and it doesn't take as much energy that way to produce a fruit. whereas a mango, it's quite large. So if anything, I'm gonna have the probably gonna have the hardest time with a mango, for sure. And I'm probably only gonna be able to keep it in a 10-gallon container at most. Maybe I'll try to up it and see what happens. Maybe put it in the 20-gallon. If it's not giving me as much fruit as I'd like. But like I said, it's really nice that these cherries can, they produce smaller fruit, and they actually all taste good from the videos I saw and the reviews I saw of the fruit. There's one guy out there that literally just tastes every fruit he can. I love his videos. I love watching his videos. I hope you guys also kind of are open to trying different things. I know that's really what my channel's been all about since the beginning, is seeing what works and what doesn't work. And so far, if you put enough research, the majority of this stuff works. I haven't failed on too many things just yet, in terms of like experimenting. So I'm really excited to try this stuff, and I'm gonna keep you guys updated and, you know, and show you guys how these things are doing. What's really interesting, not only Logies, but there's also other nurseries that will ship some tropical fruit trees. It's quite hard to find a nursery that does that, just because nurseries, there's a ton of them out there for tropical fruit. You know, if you live in a warmer climate, somewhere in like California or Florida or Texas, there's nurseries everywhere. And the problem with that is that it kind of floods the market, and people don't really want to ship these trees, because the people that can grow these trees are only living in those areas. But certain nurseries have found the niche to ship these trees, and I'm very grateful that they've chosen to do that, because then it opens it up for someone like me that has a greenhouse to try and grow these. In fact, when I have a larger property, I'll have a larger greenhouse, and I'll heat it, and I'm hoping to put a lot more tropical fruit trees in the ground, actually, in a greenhouse. I want to show you guys my starfruit tree and my lychee tree. I got these two from Pine Island Nursery. That's another nursery that will ship fruit trees. This is a variety called Flang Tongue. I hope it's good. I honestly wasn't too picky on the varieties, because the guy was really trying to help me and trying to figure out, you know, what would work and what wouldn't work in a container, because lots of tropical fruit trees just get massive, and they have large, vigorous roots. They don't have many fibrous roots. But there's been documented knowledge out there of, as an example, something like a starfruit that is fruited at a young age and can bear these fruits. In fact, they flower quite frequently. Here's some flowers right here, and I'm hoping they form some fruits, because this is quite a nice tree already as it is. It was shipped to me in a 3-gallon for quite a cheap price. I have to say, I think I spent probably $100 on two different trees, and they're already at the 3-gallon size. So that's really nice. They also have lots of new growth on them, just everywhere. This seems like a very vigorous tree. Kind of reminds me of the leaf of like a moringa leaf almost. It just looks, the shape of it and the way it grows, it comes out in like these stems, and then the leaves are on the outsides of the stems, in that kind of fashion. So the other tree here, like I said, is the lychee, and the lychee has put out an impressive amount of growth. I only had this tree, the both of these, the starfruit and the lychee, for a couple weeks now, maybe 2 weeks, and they already put out a ton of growth, which is really nice. It's quite interesting to see, and lots of people have said that getting a lychee to fruit is like near impossible. But there's some techniques out there of pruning that might actually make these guys fruit. The idea behind it is that after they fruit, you prune off the trees. And then once you prune the fruit, you prune back those apical buds on the trees where the fruits were, then it sends out these shoots of new growth, which is kind of what this tree is doing right now. It doesn't have like an apical bud. In fact, it looks like right here it kind of was cut off, and it sent out this new growth right here and this new growth. So I'm thinking this tree's already been like pruned and like doing what it needs to do to hopefully set some fruit. I don't think I've seen anything blooming on this guy, but there's quite a lot of new growth, like I said, and I'm just really excited for this. Really, I am, because I've never tried a lychee tree, or a lychee fruit, I should say. I have tried a starfruit tree, and what's interesting about starfruits, they actually suck. They're horrible. They taste, they're like a tomato you get at the store, and tomatoes you get at the store are not that bad, but what happens is they pick the tomatoes so early when they're like in the green stage, and they get them with the ethylene gas and it ripens the fruit. So by the time it gets to the store, it's already red. But when they picked it, it's not anywhere near ripe. And it's a similar thing with the starfruit. And starfruit they're picked super early. So the starfruit I did have at the store was pathetically bad. It tasted to me like it wasn't sweet at all. I knew it was kind of ripe, but it actually wasn't ripe enough, for sure. So, partly a ripeness issue, but partly just because it was picked so damn early. And I hear that if you can get a starfruit to ripen on the tree, and you pick it at the right time, they're actually quite tasty. Like, really tasty. So, yeah, just excited for that. And the last thing I have here that I want to unbox for you guys is this bad boy. And if you got to the end, congrats, because this is, I think, gonna be the coolest thing of the video. I got this from a company called Bare Bones on Amazon. Pretty cheap. It's like, it's packaged pretty cool. Let's see what the hell's in here. Okay, I have to cut this. Let's see if I can get this open with one hand. Here we go. So look what it is. It is a Hori Hori, the ultimate tool. It is actually the ultimate tool. I haven't used one, so I can't really say from my firsthand knowledge, but what I've seen people on the internet and people talk about, they just rave about this knife, this blade. And I'm really, oh my God, it's quite, you can tell how well made this thing is. Holy shit. What's interesting about this Hori Hori, and I've just learned about some of these knives, some of these gardening tools, did some research on them. But what I've learned is that knives in general need to have, oh God, what's the term? But essentially, they need to be a knife that is full tongue, I think it's called? Tang? Full tang, I think that's what it is. And if they're not full tang, they just don't have the leverage. And what tang means is that you get this metal and it goes all the way through the handle to the end. So you have like the leverage when you're digging with this or you're cutting with the knife, whatever. Yeah, so this is, I believe, a full tang knife. And what's really cool about this, I saw their video. This is like a nice hammer. You can actually use it as a hammer and hammer things in, because this is a steel carbide, I think it's a carbide steel blade and a carbide steel end here to the handle, and it acts like a hammer. So cool. What's nice about the Hori Hori is it has a part here for cutting different things. You could cut like something like comfrey that I'm growing now. And on this side, there's a blade on it. Not as sharp, I will say. There's also a can opener, a bottle opener on here, I'm sorry. Not that I drink all that much or need a freaking can opener on my, need a can opener on my Hori Hori. It's kind of hipster, I have to say. But, yeah, I think it's a nice, cool touch. And then you've got this part right here, which is like a nice measuring stick. These little notches here, I think, represent inches. And then what's nice is you can dig in real deep and get the get like weeds out or dig holes quite easily. This is just a really quality blade. I'm shocked, okay? I only spent $30 on this thing. There are some cheaper ones out there, but this thing just goes above and beyond. I really like this thing. So I guess the last thing now to do is just use it. So here we've got the Hori Hori, and here is a weed. We're gonna see how easy it is to get this thing out of here. I wanna point out that the tip of this is not that sharp. It's sharp, but it's not gonna stab you. I mean, this isn't like a really sharp knife you could kill someone with. I guess you could. You could definitely kill someone if you put enough force on it, but this isn't like a really, really, really sharp blade. Like, I'm putting my finger on this and I'm not getting cut at all. I guess this side over here is much sharper. Anyway, let's see how easy this is to get this out. Weeds have very deep tap roots, I guess, which is kind of the problem of them. So here we go. I just loosened the soil here. And, I guess I'll have to use this. So that was pretty easy. I got it out. There's actually a worm on the end there. See him. So yeah, that was relatively easy, and I bet you if I didn't have a camera in my hand, it probably would have been a lot smoother. So yeah. Pretty interesting tool here, the Hori Hori. Definitely recommend you guys get this guy. But anyway, thanks for watching, and I try to make this unboxing pretty interesting. I'm definitely going to keep you guys updated and tell you, you know, how the Hori Hori is doing, and especially those tropical fruit trees I now have in the greenhouse. So, yeah, like I said, thanks for watching, and have a great day, guys.